Welcome to the coolest stuff on the planet.
Well, hello there, everybody. Fancy meeting you here. My name is Rachel, and that guy sitting across from me is Matthew. Say hi, Matt.
Hi, everybody.
Now, today's episode, you might remember last week's was Christmas, Christmas trees. Mm-hmm. And this week is another seasonal one. We are going to focus on New Year's Eve because this episode is slated to publish on New Year's Eve.
Yes, exactly.
So, we thought it'd be fun to take a look at how the world celebrates New Year's Eve all around the world.
Yeah, it's an ancient tradition. People have been celebrating for hundreds, if not thousands of years because they made it to the next year and they're excited about what's going to happen
in the
next
year. They want a party.
Year. Exactly.
Let's start in New York City. I think that's a good place
to
start.
Okay, sure.
So, in New York City, they have been celebrating in Times Square since 1904. And here are the origins of this very popular tradition.
Okay.
The celebration was originally somewhere else, but it was moved to Times Square in 1904 to commemorate the opening of the headquarters of the New York Times.
That's a good thing to celebrate.
Yeah. It caught on like wildfire, and today people gather in huge numbers to watch this event. And it's caught on all around the world.
Nice. Well, in Spain, this is really cool. They eat grapes, which sounds a little strange, but check it out. So when the clock strikes midnight, you know the clocks that go ding, ding, you have to eat one grape for each strike. It's supposed to give you and bestow good luck for each month of the next year.
So here's a tradition that is very relevant to you and me, Matt, because we record in Atlanta, Georgia. So in the South, it is traditional to eat black-eyed peas on New Year's Eve, just after midnight.
I missed out on that one, I guess.
So your family doesn't partake in that tradition?
Yeah, no.
But no black-eyed peas?
No.
That's kind of a fun one. I almost want to try that one this year. And I think Scotland has my very favorite New Year's Eve tradition called Hogmanay. And Hogmanay is the Scottish tradition that was shaped by ancient pagan winter solstice, Roman, and Viking celebrations. And it's resulted in kind of a very unique set of traditions.
Yeah. It's definitely an amalgamation of several different things. So here are a couple of the traditions. Once it strikes midnight, you have to go clean your house vigorously as much as you can and then burn some juniper. And this is kind of a way to get the evil spirits out of your home.
Oh, so a lot like Chinese New Year.
Very similar to Chinese
New
Year. Bonfires are a huge tradition, which is a lot of fun. There's, I don't have the town written down here. But there's one town that some of the town folk have been upset because there's so many huge bonfires that I think it's causing problems.
Oh.
There's another town called Stonehaven.
Oh, they have my favorite tradition.
So there are at least, I think there are 60 men that run around outside and swing these giant balls of fire above their head. Do you know much about this?
I don't. I imagine it's similar to the kind of like chasing away, evil spirits or whatever with fire. Kind of like fireworks are in Chinese New Year and in general.
Nice. It's more of a hands-on approach, I guess.
Definitely. Those celebrations are, you have them in small places, of course, but oftentimes they're also celebrated in, big numbers in cities like Edinburgh and Glasgow. Mm-hmm. They have these massive outdoor celebrations. And in fact, that's really common around the world. Like in cities in Paris and Rome and Prague and London, you have people gathering in these public squares and places like that, and just having this big block party, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Some other much more common New Year's Eve traditions around the world. We're just going to list a few.
Mm-hmm.
Fireworks, like we said.
Oh, yes.
Toasting. Streamers, kissing.
Yeah. Sparklers. Remember those?
Yeah.
I know, just mostly spending time with family and with friends. Oh, and then once you're with them, you get really intoxicated. At least in my experience, that's what's happened.
Like intoxicated by life?
Yes, and sometimes spirits.
Spirits.
Depending on whatever.
You get very spirited.
Yes. And then sometimes you'll just have a little parade, sometimes by yourself, or sometimes an actual parade.
It sounds like maybe Matt's New Year's Eve, your own little Matt parade.
Yes, it brings me nightmares. but yeah, that's pretty much it. Whatever brings you merriment, that's what you do on New Year's Eve.
It's just a way of having a good time and kind of looking forward to the year ahead.
Mm-hmm.
You got a fresh slate. So But you tell us, how do you celebrate New Year's Eve? Do you have any special traditions or do anything kind of crazy? Or do you just watch the ball drop with your family?
And, do you set anything on fire?
Do you swing fireballs over your head? What do you do? You know, let us know. We'd love to know.
Exactly. And oh, don't forget, download the How Stuff Works iPhone app. It is of grave importance that you do this if you have an iPhone.
Oh, yeah, because you can learn all about New Year's traditions and Christmas and all sorts of things to fill your brain with.
Exactly.
For the coming, the new year, you want to be full of knowledge for 2011.
Right, in the palm of your hand.
Yeah, check that out. And I think that's it for this year, right, Matt?
Yep,
we're wrapping it up.
2010 is over, guys.
Yeah. So I guess I can say now we will see you next year for more cool stuff.
On the planet.
For more on this and thousands of other topics, visit howstuffworks.com and let us know what you think. Email travelpodcast@howstuffworks.com. Don't forget to check out our other podcasts, free on iTunes.